welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel. It is Lee. I missed you guys. I really missed you guys. I am getting back on track because I have goals. And reporting live to YouTube now. Reporting live from the gutter, bitch. I ain't talking money. Big money, bitch. I ain't talking big money. Y'all already know. But I'm back. I'm back with some good news. I'm still it.
I'm that bitch. Yeah. Been that bitch, still that bitch. Will forever be that bitch.
Forever be that bitch.
You too, though. But I am. I'm back. I feel wonderful this Saturday. I feel wonderful. But I did want to come back, connect, and recap on what's been going on with me in these few weeks. I haven't been staying up with my videos, but I've been still doing my work in the midst of me not doing my videos. But I was watching, I love me some Neville Goddard. I love Neville Goddard. I love Alan Watts. They are two great philosophers that I follow. And I was listening to a lecture by Neville, and it was called Time to Act. And that's why I'm reporting live from 343 right now, because it's time to act. And it was a great lecture. It was really a great lecture. And even like in your times of not doing, long as you doing, I don't know if that makes sense.
I was playing.
But even if you're not working on a main goal, be working on the smaller ones, you know, and the smaller ones help you with the major goal that you look forward to accomplishing anyway. So it's never like no loss. You never like not being efficient, not being effective. So even though I haven't been doing my videos, I've been making sure I'm effective in other areas of my life. But I'm like, no, Lee, let's get back on these videos because you do your thing. And I honestly love being behind the camera, and I can't deny that. So I'm like, let's go full throttle. Fill the tank up. Run that fucker. Run it.
No! 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 We did that shit!
You know, so I'm like, yeah, I'm there. Like Neville said, it's time to act. It's a good lecture if you guys want to check it out. It's on YouTube, Neville Goddard. Time to act. I love Brian. His YouTube page is Reality Revolution. It is awesome for our, if you got that mind, you'll love his page. You'll love his page. It's wonderful. But the lecture was basically speaking on when it's really time to act. You know, you can have all your faith, and faith without works is dead. Not in the way of when they say works is meaning hard work. You gotta work hard, you gotta struggle, you gotta do all of that to accomplish or to have your dreams. Nah, I don't believe that. But you do have to stay consistent.
I'm take it or fucking leave it, but I put in the motherfucking work. I put in the work.
Queen.
Good night.
His meaning and his description of it, I love it, because as Neville explained, you are God, you know? And I'm gonna make a video on that, my spiritual journey, as far as how I realize that I am, you know, in that hole you see in the back, I am. And a lot of people use the phrase, and I was using the phrase as well and not really living up to the phrase, like, I am this, you know, saying the affirmations and all of that. But how much faith do you really have behind your I am, knowing that I am means God? And when you speak that, you're speaking for yourself. You're speaking it into existence. You, the power of the tongue, that, all of that comes in play, but it comes a time to act on it, you know? And I love how he expressed how your faith is expressed by your actions. You know, if you truly believe that you are who you say you are, you know, act on it, you know? And it is a time to act. And act when you feel that you have that state that you want to, that state that you want to be in, that you see yourself in. When you persist, you have to constantly persist in that state. So like, it's no more like, I believe I'm this, I believe I can do this, I can believe I can do that. Like, after you done worked out them negative thoughts and you done worked your way up in confidence, apply it in your life. apply it in your life now, you know, and I'm to that point where I have been applying, but I ain't been applying as hard as I can. And I can acknowledge that. And now I'm at a time where it's like, let's get it. Let's get it. Let's all get it.
I'm trying to get it, little baby. I'm trying to get it.
I'm trying to get it.
Hey, I'm trying to get it, little baby.
I'm trying to get it.
I'm trying to get it.
I'm trying to get it.
Hey, I'm trying to get it, little baby.
I'm trying to get it.
I want the best wine. It's time to drink wine. It's time to apply that knowledge. It's time to go out with them feelings that you feel. It's time to accomplish them goals. It's time to live in that image that you see yourself being. It's time to just live it. Just live it. The more we keep thinking that we have to become it, the further you are from it. The more you just accept you already it, you got it. You got it. The more you keep thinking like, okay, I gotta become this figure. Okay, so I gotta be like this. And they say, okay, so I gotta be like in this image, or okay, I feel like I don't got it enough. You still feel like you don't got it, you know? You just keep thinking. Your mind will continue to make you think and
the name. Come on, baby, what's the name?
It's gonna have that doubt. That's why your only opponent is you, you know? So the moment you is really have to ask yourself who you wavering with, you know? After a while, you continue to build your momentum up and you change them negative thoughts. You don't attach yourself to that old person no more. And that's the only way to separate the two. Like, you don't even separate them. It's one, you know? Like, anybody who watching, like, the old me, the old things I used to do, I'm still the same person, but my reality has changed. And since my reality changed, everything around me has changed. You know, so even though I may not engage in condone or it don't even exist in my world no more, you know, I'm still the same person. Just all the things that didn't serve me left, you know, but people say they may think you changed, but you changed for the better.
When I had my vision, you couldn't see. I'm off to better things. I'm only doing shit that's gonna make me elevate. Only one people around that's gonna make me.
And that's neither here or there, honestly. Because you're not gonna get where you wanna get to making everybody else happy. And you damn sure ain't gonna get to where you wanna get to staying the same. So I don't mind who looks at me any differently. I don't mind who says, oh, she's different now, or that ain't how Lee used to be. But how is Lee used to, how did Lee used to be? You know, how can somebody else tell me who the hell I am? You know, unless I allow them to. And I allowed other people to tell me who I was for so many years. So they might know the old Lee very well. Very, very well. You know, very well. They might just know her. But I shuck a lot of that shit off, you know, and it doesn't even lie in me anymore. And those same people who probably think I'm different, they don't resonate with me anymore. So everything works together for the good.
Period.
Everything works together for the good. Like, we don't sweat anything. Like, you don't sweat anything. Like I say, stay consistent and persist in the assumption, in the state, in the goals, in all that you want. Stay there. Stay there. And that's why I'm coming back to YouTube and being more consistent and hitting y'all with that flavor for your ear, because consistency is important. And I found that out on my time away, you know, and I'm like, damn, I really came to the conclusion, like, I see why staying consistent is so important, because staying consistent is equivalent to persistent in the assumption of who you are, you know. And on them time, in them times when you're not being consistent and you're not staying true to who you truly are or what you want out of life or your future that you plan, then what you doing, honestly?
I was just bullshitting, and you know this, man.
You know, so it's like, okay, I get it now. The more I persist and the more I stay consistent, it makes it easier for me to believe that I am who I say I am. You know, the less that I do, but yet I sit back and say I want it, it's hard for me to believe. That's why that's time to act. It's time to act. It's time to act. We've been dreaming on it. We've been imagining it. We've been writing it down. You know, all those methods, they are great. They're wonderful. But like Neville said, it is time for us to act, you guys. It is time for us to act. So I'm staying consistent. I'm staying happy. I'm staying joyful. I'm staying in bliss. I'm staying in alignment. And you know you there because it feels so good. It feels so good. It doesn't feel like I'm in a field where I'm forcing anything around me. I don't feel like I'm forcing anyone to acknowledge me, see me, value me. I cut all that shit out. I cut all of that out. I've really been working on my beliefs. Like, I really listen to myself, and I really been switching that record.
Yo, chill. Chill. Don't bump the table. I appreciate it. Yo, play something I can dance to and I won't.
And those new tracks that's been playing in my head, they doing wonders for the chick. They doing wonders for me. They are. Yo, put a different track on. Just know, no matter what you doing, like I said, you can be, if you skip out on the major goal, if you have the little goals, make sure you doing something, you know? Make sure you doing something, not for others, but for yourself. You know, make yourself feel good by investing in yourself and doing for yourself. You know, I was speaking with somebody the other day, and she happened to ask me, like, well, Lee, how do you love yourself? Like, how do you love yourself? And I was like, really sitting on the couch on the phone, like, damn.
Quick, what's the number for 911? How do I know? Let's go!
It was kind of hard for me to... Not hard, but I struggled at first with contemplating on how the hell do I love myself, you know? But then, like, sit with yourself. Sit with yourself. I'm telling you, nobody can give you a better answer than you can when you just let all those thoughts aside and really sit in silence. I've been with myself. I've been working with myself. I want to get through alone. Not because I want to be alone for the rest of my life, but because... in this life, you need to know how to be the fuck alone. Honestly, like, you need to know how to handle you. You need to know how to maneuver, regardless if this go wrong or that go wrong. And I feel like I accomplished that within myself. You know, whatever comes, comes. Whatever goes, goes. But it took me a long time to get to that point, to be okay with other people, opinions of me, other people, actions that may be caused upon me, like all of that. It took me a long time for, you know, when other people moved out, you know, even though, what's the saying, like, what you eat don't make me shit, but
let me just make it to the bathroom before I lose my bowels all over myself. Sorry.
Man, I used to be on the toilet for a lot of people, you know, because it bothered me, and this not supposed to be like this, and this, that, and the third, and that shit worry you. But in the process of loving yourself and knowing yourself, working with yourself, you, all of that shit subsides. It really does. And her ask can be like, yo, how do you love yourself? It's so crazy that we ask that question as women. You know, because 9 times out of 10, we in this predicament because, or not even in a predicament, a lot of people got to this place or got in a hole or got down and out because of a significant other, you know, or even if it wasn't a significant other, it may have been a loved one. You struggle with loving yourself, but you got to this point of struggling of loving yourself from loving others. How can we ever question how to love ourselves? We love ourselves how we love the other. That's how you start with loving yourself. Eliminate everybody else. You know what I mean? Make a list of things you felt like you did for people that betrayed you, or list all the things that you feel as if you showed love and it wasn't reciprocated. And that whole list, baby, you do that for you. That's where you start. It's so crazy when I really think of that. It's like, wow, I sat on that, and I was on a wobbly state for a minute with loving myself, but it was like until I dawned on it, like a meme said, I might be one of the only truth of a meme out there, but when you start doing what you did for others, you will learn how to love yourself. And you do that times 10. Do it times 10. Why not turn up for you? You know what I mean? Turn it up a notch. If you was only giving them love, like Teddy, if that relationship with 50, 60, give yours 100 and 120. You know what I mean? Turn that shit up for yourself. Why not? This is for you.
Get the best out of life. Treat yourself to something new. Keep your head up high in yourself. Believe in you. Believe in
you. You know, we bent over backwards for other people, you know, and you went out of your way for other people. You even tried to change yourself for other people. Make those same steps for yourself and see how you bless you. Anything else given from the outside, that's a blessing as well. But it's no greater blessing than you blessing yourself, you accomplishing your own goals, you loving you, you making it happen for you. And you ain't touch nobody else's plate? Man, please, where my crown? Where the crown? Where the award?
And I want to thank my haters too, because...
like, please, it's no better feeling. So let us all get back on track. If everybody's been working on them goals, make sure you're working on them goals. Mark them down. Get it done. Make it happen. And I look forward to seeing everybody live their best life. I look forward to you guys witnessing me live my best life.
I'ma swear I'ma do it like I never had it at. Like I never had it at.
Listen, I look forward to us all sharing all our love, all our wealth and success amongst all of us. You know, that's all I wish for all and I want for all. Happiness, success, bliss, joy, peace. You know, and yo, that's all I feel. That's all I navigate towards. That's all that gravitate towards me. That's all that's constantly on my mind now. I like how Neville in his lectures, I love how like in the end he'll do like a Q&A. Somebody usually always asks something that you probably be thinking as you listening to it. And he was speaking about thoughts, how we can't control them, you know, and what you give attention to grows. Whether you want it or not, you get what you think about. Whether you want it or not, you know. So you be very cautious and aware of what you constantly thinking in that small talk in your mind. What is that small talk, that chitter chatter to yourself? Be conscious of that. What are you talking about? Man, I be counting money on my worst day, but I'm counting money in my head. I'm having business plans in my head. I live more in my dreams. It's so crazy because you can't. I create what I want to see, and that is the best power that we have.
But I give all meaning to everything I see. If I see myself as broken, wounded, damaged, crazy, stupid, whatever, I give meaning to that.
We don't realize that we have the power to see what we want to see, you know. But going back to Neville, because y'all know I'll be getting off topic real quick. That's Lee. Y'all know I love to ramble. But if you're having good, look, I got good shit while I'm rambling. But yo, so Neville, when he was explaining the whole feelings and everything, and one of the people asked, like, as far as negative comments, and they explain like, you don't think Jesus or the greatest Buddhas or all these great people that you follow after didn't have negative thoughts? And I'm like, damn, right. You think a negative thought never came through Jesus' mind? Nah. How he explained it didn't bother him. He knew who he was. So, yo, it's be so crazy. I tried to like, oh, yo, right, okay. So, I'm driving. I'm like, what? Let some shit come across my mind. I'm about to try to work it. I'm about to handle it real quick. Y'all know? And we about to handle it. So, let it come. And be still. It can say, you can't do this. Long as I let that shit go on like a cloud, because that's all thoughts is. Thoughts is just clouds passing. I'm the sky. That's still. That's here forever. Ever still. Untouched. No matter if it rains, sleet, snow, fire, hail, whatever. The sky is always untouched. Clouds go past all day. Let it go. Just let them go. Just let them go and be still. So let it say you can't do anything. As long as you don't be like, yes, I can. Because you remember last time. And then, nah, but you know you felt last time. The moment you get into that, you believe it. And you energize them thoughts. And them and it's so crazy because thoughts have feelings, feelings connected to them. So the moment you attach a feeling next to a thought, it got you. It got you. It got you. And that's why it's followed by more negative thoughts and more negative thoughts and more negative thoughts. But you can cut that shit short real quick. Real quick. By simply not acknowledging it. And letting it pass. Letting it pass. Like, throughout this whole time, y'all, I've been telling y'all, I might not have been making a video, but I've learned and grown so much. Do something for yourself. It don't matter if it can't be shown or it can't be revealed or it's not tangible to others. Do it for yourself. And I always know, long as I'm cleaning up my inside and my mentality, I will forever flourish in this world. I don't care what nobody else say or however they may perceive me right now. Things will get better. And you can change your thought process. And we can eliminate all that negativity. All of it. All of it. And that's major. And it's so needed when it comes to manifesting and creating the life you want. You have to get that out of you. But honestly, it's all you. And to be totally true, I want to be so different when it comes to this. I want to be so different when it comes to this. It's so many people that's doing what I'm doing. You know, trying to give a word, trying to help others in a way so you guys can excel and have the lives you want. But ultimately, every tip I give you, every help or these ways and, oh, try this, try that, and this helped for me. Everybody different at the end of the day. And all these little steps and tools and guides and books and all of those are just stops along the way. That's all it is. And ways to make you think that you still have to do something or you still don't have it done enough or you still need more work. It's just a way to make you feel like you still not there yet. You know, and watching me and listening to me, I don't want people to be watching me thinking that they not there yet. I want everybody to know who watching me that you already are who you want to be. The only thing that's stopping you from really realizing that you are who you want to be is you. The faster you accept you already are that, you got it. You got it. So if you need that help, take that help. Yes. But take that help in confidence. Take that help and not in a state of thinking that, okay, after I do this, then I'll have it. Take that help more so like, oh, I like to obtain more information and more knowledge. But I know that what I'm attaining already lies in me. Switch that momentum up. Change your beliefs up, y'all. When I'm telling you just a change of a belief will open and bring so much into your life. Because it's a lot of things that you want to touch that you can't touch because of a thought that you really holding inside of your head. So until you let it go, it can't flow. You gotta let it all go. Chewy!
Don't let nobody tell you that it's over. I want you to know that, girl, you got it. You got it. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Always know you got it. I may give tips and tools and things that help me along the way, but you already have all that you want. That's all I want for people, to just know that they already have it. It makes the process and it makes the becomings so much faster and so much, it just makes everything on the roll. It just speeds everything up. It honestly do. It speeds everything up. So go out. Know you already got it. Know you already hold it. Know you already possess it. Know that it cannot be taken. And you live in that shit. Live in it. Talk it. Like money say, pop your shit. I talk my shit. I pop my shit. Okay? And know you got it. And come out there with that much confidence. Yo, I was watching this interview on Shine. Y'all know Shine out and everything, so.
Introduce like I'm Shine and you my destiny. In your diamond cluster, too much just to touch you. Perfume down to you.
I was watching this interview. I don't even know what radio station he was on, but he was on a radio station. And y'all know Shine from New York. Well, he not from New York, but he rep New York. I know he from Cross Seas or something, because I know he had to get, like, papers to come over. Whatever. But, like I said, he was on this radio show. And he rep New York, because that's what he was putting on. He was with Puffin' them. So, but I loved how he said, like, coming from up north, like, you gotta have this confidence. Like, he was talking, and like, yo, you just gotta have this confidence. And I came out with this confidence.
And it's because, you know, our lives were destined for early grave or jail. And so we had to believe in ourselves, or, you know, what's the point of waking up?
Speaking it into existence, that shit really works, because they made it happen. And before they had $2 in their pocket, they was talking that shit, okay? Okay, they believed it. They believed in them. It's rappers who felt as if that people feel as if they can't rap, but they believed in themselves to a point where it's so strong. Their belief is so strong that it has to rub off on others. It has to. It has no other choice. It has no other choice. When I'm telling you, anything is possible when you believe, not when they believe you, not when they believe you. Whatever you want, I know that I am capable. I know that if I believe it, you have to possess it first. You don't convince them. You convince you. That's the only person you gotta convince. In the moment you convince you, and it's so indulged in you, and you so into that assumption, man, it just, yo, that energy gonna connect with the right ones, with the right people, and the ones who's that's on your wavelength. And if you're talking that money, and if you want that, must believe that money coming back. It's coming back. It's coming. It's coming. It's coming. You don't have to chase a thing. I don't chase shit. I don't chase shit. I don't. And my life became so much better. And it's so crazy. I will say this. Even when I stopped chasing things, I didn't even lose some things. That's for some people who are scared to stop chasing. That comes from someone. I chase a lot of things in my life. People, places, money. I stopped. I will tell you, the right ones gravitate towards me now. When it do come, I feel the love. When it do come, I do feel that it's genuine. You know what I mean? So that's confirmation. You don't got to chase a damn thing. What resonates in you will gravitate towards you. So have that big dick energy, how they say it, or have that high energy. Have that high energy come out. I live in expectancy. Yo, be so crazy, because I really like be forgetting that I've been repeating certain things in my head, or I be forgetting. So when certain things be happening, I'll be like, oh, what? But then I'll be like, oh, I forgot all day. I've been saying something wonderful is happening to me today. You know, so when something wonderful happens to me, or something like I wasn't expecting to happen, I'll be like, oh, mad surprise. But then it dawned on me like, yo, I have been reciting that. For the last past how long? I live in this expectancy for these great things to continue to keep happening to me. But I do be forgetting sometime when it happened, because I'm just there and I'm like, oh, okay. This is a new world for me. When you come, it's a new world, it's new land. You on new hand, you on new land. Treat it as such. Also, y'all live in expectancy of good things. Live in the knowledge, knowing that you can create and be and do anything you want in this world. Why not wake up happy? Why not? You can change the scenario at any moment. Just be willing to do so. So I'm going to wrap it up. Appreciate any and all who's watching, who watches this. And I love y'all dearly. And just know all things are possible when you believe. When you believe. I love y'all. Enjoy the rest of your day.